Here's the question. Can a 382 horsepower Roadster paint a smile on your face and be fuel efficient at the same time? Buckle up and let's go for a drive.
I'm your host, Brian Max, racer, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, it's been a couple of years since we looked at the Z4. And since then, of course, the elephant in the room, the Toyota Supra, has shown up. And of course, it's been a big hit with Toyota enthusiasts. And on top of that, they've actually delivered one for drivers like us with a manual transmission. That is unfortunately not available with this Z4, but that's not to say this is anything less because it lacks a manual transmission. Anyway, before we get into what this is like to drive, let's have a look at this Z4 M40i in a little more depth. Mechanically, not much has changed since we looked at this Z4 M40i a couple of years ago, and that is not necessarily a bad thing. Under the hood is that 3-liter inline six with a single twin scroll turbo, makes 382 horsepower from 5,800 to 6,500 RPM, and 369 pounds of torque from 1,800 to 4,500 RPM. The transmission's still an 8-speed automatic. No, you can't get a manual. There's an M Sport differential in the back, and what that means is an electronically controlled limited slip type. Steering is electrically assisted and it is variable assist. Suspension's based around that double joint spring strut axle at the front, 5-link at the rear, adaptive dampers, 4-piston brake calipers at the front, single at the rear. Wheels and tires are 19s, 255 at the front, 275 wide at the back, and these are Michelin Pilot Sport non-run flats. Curb weight of this Z4 M40i is a little over 3,500 pounds. As ever, the driver interface, the cockpit, everything here is spot on. BMW knows how to deliver to drivers. I'm seated perfectly behind the wheel. The shape of the steering wheel is the right size. Lots of adjustment in the seat and the steering column to set me up perfectly here. And on top of that, this seat is wonderfully supportive. It's great for long distances and supportive when you're hustling this thing through the corners. There hasn't been a major update to this Z4, so we're not finding the curved screens and the latest gen iDrive, which is not necessarily a bad thing. Still has wireless CarPlay. There's a wireless charger here and it works wonderfully. The only thing I'd really complain about is that sometimes there's a little bit too much glare on the big screen here in the center of the dash. After that, this is very familiar BMW. The controller is here, very familiar to BMW enthusiasts as well. This is a touchscreen. It's a little bit difficult to reach from this seating position. Have to stretch to the other side of the screen, but otherwise, really can't complain about the way any of this works. It's very traditional BMW and very much driver-centric. Now, in terms of spaciousness, it's a Roadster. There's not a lot of room. There's a little bit of room in the trunk, maybe for two carry-ons. Right now, I've got a carry-on size piece in the trunk along with my backpack. There's still lots of room, but one of the funky things is there's actually a pass-through right here between the seats. I suppose you could carry skis in there if that's your thing, but that wouldn't work for me because I don't ski. In terms of visibility, this is a Roadster, and my rule with convertibles is to have the top down all the time, and when the top is down, you can see in all 360 degrees. Yeah, this is quick for a 3,500 pound car with less than 400 horsepower. Does 0 to 60 in under 4 seconds. That is just incredible. And that speaks to how good the tires are, as well as that e-diff in the back. Just puts down power flawlessly. Can't complain about that at all. No trouble putting down power. This is very, very good at acceleration. And then on top of it, we'll talk about how it handles in a little bit. I think the e-diff is one of the highlights of this Z4. It's just flawless in terms of putting down power anytime, anywhere, whether it's a tight corner and we're rocketing out of it or a big sweeper, no trouble putting down power. And what that does for you as the driver, it gives you tremendous confidence when you're hustling this Z4. As ever, the 8-speed automatic in performance-oriented BMWs tends to work flawlessly, and that is par for the course here. It's absolutely spot on, shifts smoothly, and of course you do have manual control. There are a couple of different algorithms. I drive the transmission in sport because it tends to hold on to gears a little bit longer and works exactly the way I want it. Then of course, if I do want manual control of the gearbox, well, we've got the flappy paddles here on the back of the steering wheel. Like all BMW inline sixes, at least the modern ones with the turbos, this is just a very flexible motor. Tremendous torque lower in the rev range through the meaty part of the rev range. And then if you want to make maximum power, well, it rewards you when you drive this thing all the way up to near its red line. That makes maximum power up near the top, and it's just a delight to drive. And on top of that, this motor is so smooth. It's buttery smooth, and there's nothing like a good inline six. The way BMW's tuned the exhaust in sport mode anyway is it'll give you a little bit of pop and burble from time to time, and that just enhances the overall driving experience. Dynamically, that is where this Roadster shines. It's just a joy to drive anytime when we're cruising like we are now, or when we're attacking some corners. This thing just works flawlessly as a great companion when we're carving corners. Absolutely love it for that. Ride is fairly compliant. Yes, it is on the stiff side because there are M badges all over the place here, but otherwise I'm not going to complain about the ride. None of my passengers have complained, and I really dig the overall chassis setup here. It's great in the corners and great when you're cruising. And speaking of attacking corners, when you are playing with this and get near its limits, it is very, very neutral. I'm very impressed with the overall balance here. Yeah, it's 3,500 pounds, not 3,000 pounds, certainly not less than 3,000 pounds, but you've got great chassis feel and a lot of confidence in the corners. A lovely, lovely balance. And if you're on top of the car, you can really dance with this at its limits. It's an absolute joy to drive anywhere, anytime. And that's the beauty of this Z4. It's just a wonderful all-around roadster. Paints a smile on your face anytime you're driving it. Steering is perhaps a little lighter than I would like, and not a lot of feel or feedback comes through the steering wheel, but you've got great chassis feel. And if you are like me, you'll appreciate that. And you're able to get on top of the car because there's such great feel through the chassis. And on top of that, brakes are flawless. I've got millimeter control with these brakes. They're absolutely spectacular. And of course, BMW knows how to do brakes well. Excellent modulation, excellent control. And then of course, when you're dancing with this near its limits, you've got precise control with the brake pedal. How do you spec yours? Well, first things first, everybody I've run into with this car loves this color. This is called Thunder Night Metallic. Of all names, it's called Thunder Night Metallic, but everybody loves it. It is stunning in person. Hopefully it's coming through on camera. Base price in the US is a little over $66,000. And as tested, this is a little over $72,000. In Canada, it's $80,000 base and about $87,000 as tested before freight and local taxes. In terms of speccing yours, well, it comes very well equipped as it is in terms of performance options. Great suspension, great brakes, and of course the Michelin Pilot non-run flat tires. So really your only options are colors, and this color combination is stunning in person. And of course it does paint a smile on everyone's face. But more importantly, if you're looking at a Z4, this color ain't so bad. Choose the colors you like, but this one is a stunner. My verdict, well, let's start with fuel consumption because that is the question of the day. And you're ready for this? I'm getting about 26 miles per gallon or 9 liters per 100 kilometers for my Canadian friends. And for me, that is just ridiculous because I'm not afraid to use the throttle in this Z4. That just blows my mind, but that speaks to the engineering that's gone into this Z4. As for this being a roadster, well, it's a delight to drive, paints a smile on my face, and really in this Thunder Night metallic paints a smile on everyone's face who's come across this. This is just a stunner in person. And as for being behind the wheel, well, it's just an incredible roadster. Overall, there's nothing like the driving experience a roadster provides. And if you haven't had one in your life, you definitely need one. And if you have a preference for BMWs, well, you can't go wrong with this Z4 M40i. Hey guys, wanna know something? There's actually a turn signal stock in this BMW, and it works.